Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Aqueduct Racetrack here on Sunday. It is the 5th of January, 2020. You're going to look at the 7th race from Aqueduct, but before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for race courses around the world. Let's get to the 7th from Aqueduct, which is an allowance optional claimer purse $80,000, race for 4-year-olds and upwards, never won 10,000 three times on the main claim starter or Stafford allowance race, which never won 4 races. Optional claim price of $80,000. We have a field of 5 horses going to the main track, the distance of ground of 1,600 meters, or the mile trip on the main track, 1,600 meters, 1 mile, main track. The top selection here, we're going to go to the 5-horse Veracity. I'm going to go 5-3-2-1 in the superfecta. 5-3-2-1 super. Top selection, 5-horse Veracity. The 7-year-old horse by Distorted Humor. James Lawrence trains. Julio Correa gets the mount. The horse's most recent outing came 27th of November at Penn National against stakes competition. 6 furlongs in the Fabulous Strike Stakes. And the horse finished 5th by 6¾ lengths there. And it was just a little bit wide and just really never quickened up. It wasn't the day to win. Friends Fire just put on a show that day and went knocked that out, I believe, in the Garland of Roses, if I'm not mistaken, or something like that. But this horse just wasn't getting into it. I believe it was Gravesend, actually. But it just wasn't his day to win. Coming down in class to a 7 furlong or to the mile trip today, which I think he'll love. I think he's sitting on a very good run. Before the lounge race, 65,000 at Laurel, Sloppy Seal going 6 furlongs on Halloween. The horse finished 2nd by 1/4 lengths. It was his first start in 14 months, and he had a great turn of foot. You know, closed up well. There wasn't anything bad about that run. He probably needed the race, though, since it was first off the break, and then the Pat O'Brien of 2018 at Santania, 7 furlongs under the previous care of Phil D'Amato. The horse finished 3rd by 9½ lengths, and he just really never got into it. Catalina Cruz ran a terrific race. The second place finisher, Battle of Midway, ran a great race. May he rest in peace. This horse just wasn't getting to him. And then before that, Del Mar, 5 furlongs, optional 100th. The horse finished 4th by 4 lengths. It was wide, and again, just never had the run. Before that was in 2017, was under the training care of Kath Lynch, and he ran some decent races in the Mid-Atlantic and here in New York. In 2016, the horse was on the early Derby trail, actually ran in 2nd in the Drome behind Flexibility when it was run on the old inner track here at Aqueduct. That's how long ago it was. And then actually finished 2nd behind Sunny Ridge in the Withers of 2016, where he just didn't have the best beginnings, but he still ran his heart out there. He has some class. I think he went here 5-2. Let's give this 7-year-old horse another victory, his first victory since July of 2017. So to recap my selection for the 7th from Aqueduct, let's take the 5-horse Veracity. We'll go 5-3-2-1 in the superfecta. So good luck to all. Please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5.